you know, get to understand what are the new developments, what are the new areas, what are the new choices that could be available for them to take it forward. So here we are today with an exclusive session on the Allied Health Sciences and the way forward. Before we move on to the speakers, I would like to take the opportunity of introducing the speakers for today and the topics that would be presented by them. I take the opportunity of introducing our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. K.N.B. Murthy. Sir is a professor for Computer Science Engineering and the Vice Chancellor at Dayanand Sagar University. Sir has been the former Vice Chancellor for PES University at Bengaluru. Sir holds a Bachelor's degree in Electrical Power Engineering, Master's degree in Electrical Engineering from India Institute of Science, and a PhD in Computer Science and Engineering from IIT Madras. Sir has worked as a research specialist in parallel computing at New Mexico State University, US. Sir is currently a member of the Karnataka State Higher Education Council and the Academic Senate member of IIIT Dharwad. Sir, a warm welcome to you.
Thank you, Sindhak.
Our next speaker for the day is the Honorable Dean, Dr. Pushpa Sarkar. She is the Dean for School of Allied Health Sciences and Basic Sciences at Dayanand Sagar University. She has been the former Dean and Director for the Government Medical College at Mandya and a total of 32 years of experience in the field. She has been the former Director at Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences. Ma'am, a very warm welcome to you.
Thank you, Mrs. Shinde.
Our speaker number three for the day is Dr. Shilpa HD. She's a professor and head of department at Department of Biochemistry at Dr. Chandrama Dayanand Sagar Institution for Medical Education and Research, also called as CDSIMR. With more than 12 years of experience in teaching biochemistry and in diagnostics, she's been a gold medalist in MBBS at Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences. She's trained internal auditor and conducted many audits for various laboratories. She is presently the professor and the HOD for biochemistry at CDSIMR. A warm welcome to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Shinde.
And our next speaker for the day would be Dr. Prashant Kumar M. He is the professor and HOD for Department of Physiology at Dr. Chandrama Dayanand Sagar Institution for Medical Education and Research. He has over 20 years of teaching experience for UG and PG courses for MBBS, BPT, Allied Health Sciences, and Nursing. He was the former chairman for the Board of Studies at Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences. A warm welcome to you, Dr. Prashant.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I would now like to invite our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. K.N.B. Murthy, sir, to share his views and set the context. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Shinde. It gives me immense pleasure to be with all of you this morning. I'm extremely happy that Dayanand Sagar University has been organizing several campus info sessions to provide information to the students for making a right career choice. Whenever we make a career choice, the program of study which you're going to choose plays an important role. How do you go about doing this? You need to have four or five inputs for making the decision. One decision that you need, or one input that you need, is to know what the future is going to be. Second, you need to know what is your career aspiration and career path, which career path you would like to pursue. The next, you need to decide what will be the program study that you need to study to achieve that career path. The last, which institution to be selected for doing that program study. Let me briefly touch upon each of these points and set the context so that my co-panelists would give you more information about what I have say. First, what the future is going to look like. Three or four things are very clear as far as the future is concerned. Number one, future will be far different from what we see today, because there are a lot of changes that are going to happen in view of evolution of technology. There are a lot of technology being used in every walk of life. Thereby, the future is far different. Therefore, it's going to have complex disruption. That's one thing that all of us need to remember. The second, as a future career growth is concerned, the kind of skills that we have are going to be far different from the skills which we need to possess in the future. There are a lot of skills which have been indicated, several skills. Some of them are communication is going to be critical. The second skill is the virtual collaboration, using a platform for virtually meeting through a network, what we are doing today. This kind of knowledge is required. Social intelligence becomes very important. Social intelligence means, how do you connect to the people in a deeper and a direct way? That's the third skill that's required. Therefore, this is the kind of future that you're going to look at. The next thing that's also been predicted as our future is concerned, it's about the opportunities. Opportunities are going to be plenty. The kind of opportunities that they're going to see are phenomenal. At least 4 to 5 times more than what we see today. The only difference is the kind of job roles, the kind of titles that we see today will be far different from the job roles and titles that we're going to see in the future. Therefore, opportunities are going to be there. All that is required is you need to possess those skills, possess the requisite mindset to achieve that career path. That is exactly about the future. You also need to understand that the healthcare is going to be the priority sector in the future. Therefore, the jobs for healthcare professionals are going to be abundant. It's going to grow at least about 10 to 12% per year. Therefore, there's no need to worry about the future as far as the healthcare sector is concerned. That's all about the future, which I wanted to give the input. The second input I wanted to give is with regard to the option, the career path. What is the career path that you can choose? The career path could be a job in an industry, could be an administration kind of a thing, in a government job. Your aspiration to pursue research further, or it could be a teaching is another option that you can look at, or you can look at social service as a career path. If this career path is very clear, then it becomes that much you have clarity with regard to what you need to do. Whenever you are decided about a career path, what you want to be, then one important thing that you also need to do is, what is the talent that you have? Audit the talent. Do you have the right talent to pursue that career path? For example, if you want to work in industry, do you have the skills like communication? Do you have that social intelligence? Do you have the skill of collaboration, etc.? You need to look at that. If you do not have, you need to be ready to get those skills, because you would like to pursue a career path of working in the industry. Therefore, that's the second step that you need to do. The third step that you need to do is program of study. Which program of study you need to study? There are multiple program options. Because you have completed your plus two, you can pursue a BTEC engineering program, you can do a management program, or you can do a BSc biotechnology program, or you can do a BSc in medical and medical laboratory technology, medical imaging, radiology, etc. There are multiple options. Therefore, put down all the possible programs of study or courses that you can pursue. Then start prioritizing which program of study would give you the career path that you are interested in, which would make you much easier. Make a list, then start prioritizing. Put the order number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I would do this first. If I don't get the first one, I look at the second one. That's how you need to make order. There's a third thing that you need to do. The last thing that you need to do is, which institute study this program study? Let's say you have decided the program study as BSc Medical Laboratory Technology. If there's a program study you would like to pursue, then you need to decide which institute is the best institute for offering this program. The institute which gives you the kind of skills required for that job opportunity, career path. The institute which provides an ambience or the environment for pursuing that. Next, you also need to look at which institute had the support system. Support system is the placement kind of a thing, the student club kind of a thing, faculty of higher order who can provide you the kind of motivation required. That's the kind of decision that you have to take about the institute. Any institute which understood the future, any institute which provides all the facilities, the faculty, the support system, is the institute you need to pursue. Having given you the inputs about all the four different things, now I'll tell you, Dayanand Sagar University is offering a series of programs, about 5 different programs in allied health sciences. The best part of these programs is that all these programs are being offered in a medical college. Thereby, you get everything that you want. You will not find this kind of facility, this kind of environment, this kind of support system in any other institute that you can think of. For Dayanand Sagar University has understood what is the future is going to be. Therefore, any student who's going to join Dayanand Sagar University for any program of study, I can assure you that the career path would be really bright and tremendous. With these few words, I thank the organizers for inviting me to be a part of this webinar, and also thank all of you for a patient listening. I request my co-panelists to provide you more information about the allied health sciences and also the program study which are offered at Dayanand Sagar University. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Always a pleasure listening to you. I would now like to take the opportunity of inviting our Honorable Dean, Dr. Pushpa Sarkar, and she would be touching upon the topic on the career opportunities available under the Allied Health Sciences. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Shinde. Thank you so much. Our Honorable Vice Chancellor has given you a broad view and has spoken so much to you about all the options open to you all regarding the various courses available across, because all of you are second PO or 12th pass students. And I'm addressing these dear students now. You know that, as sir said earlier, you have taken your science stream so that you get into streams which requires a basic plus two in science subjects of physics, chemistry, and biology. So you had something in mind when you wanted to do this, when you took up this science stream. So there may not be a particular focus, but you had something in mind where you would go further. So now, usually, what was the idea earlier was that, like, you know, let my results come. Based on the results and based on the percentage I score, maybe I'll decide what I would take up. Now the onus is larger. Now there are no exams, as you know, and now it's high time that you decide what you want to do. Now how you go about this is that One is passion. Now, many of you had a passion. I want to become a doctor when I grow up. I want to become a lawyer, engineer. That's a passion. I want to be this. I want to be that. There's a desire. That's what you want to say. So, but passion is not enough. You also require to, your ability also is required. And you know that. How you're faring in your studies, how hard you can work. Because this differs across the courses and the time you impart. I suppose you take a medical profession, you have hardly any time for yourself. You need to impart large time of yours, the entire day, most of the time, to impart into your education system, into your studies mainly, where you have to do away with so many other parameters. Now is the time regarding your ability also, what is the course you want to take up. Then third thing is the capacity of finance. That is not up to you. It's of course of your parents. Without undermining anybody, I also want you all to know that now the medical course is very expensive, right? So either you have to be so meritorious so that you secure a seat in the government institutions where the fees is decent, or you need to go in for a heavy financial burden. That also you should know. So this is based on your financial position also. You need to choose the courses of which is affordable to you. That's not the major criteria, but it's also one of the criteria how you choose a course. Then you also think of, suppose if I'm doing this course, where will I place next? What will be my future? What will be my placements? This is what you think of. That is also very important to think in that way. So that you should know that in any of the course, whatever course you do, you should be the best. You should excel in your particular course to have a good placement. You cannot think, I do this course, my placement is secure. It's not so. So you should be good enough to get the placement. And finally, it is a job security. Once I land in a job, how secure is this job? Suppose if I get laid off, can I find an alternative job immediately? All this, you have to think of all these lines before you select what career you want to do, what's the job you want to do. This is what's required. Now, coming to all this, putting all this into your mind, now, as I told you, it's the right time for you to think of all this and choose all your careers. Now, coming to today's webinar, we are focusing on Allied Health Sciences, which Dayanand Sagar University is offering. Coming to this point of view, I would want to say that, now, what is the scenario now? What's happening in India? So you see the ad. India mein kya chal raha hai? There's an ad, okay, for a perfume or a deodorant, which I don't want to mention here. There's a fog chal raha hai. It's not so. Kya chal raha hai? They say that it's pandemic. Everybody says it's pandemic. Everybody knows what is COVID-19, and what is coronavirus, what are the measures to be. So everywhere is a health scenario. It's a health sector. Each entire world is concentrating on the health sector as of now, as of today, what's going on. And it's also come to everybody's notice the deficiencies or the acute shortage in this healthcare workers. Now, the concentration was more on doctors, the nurses, the next, if you think of, whom else do you think of in that? Maybe some public health officials. Now, if you don't know, I would want to mention, there are more than 52 to 58 courses which are listed, but more than that, you have these allied health courses which are required to act as an adjunct to help out the medical profession. So what are these? Now, when you come to the healthcare sector, now across the globe, it's been the healthcare sector is growing enormously in terms of finance, in terms of employment, and job security, all of this. Now, India too is growing. And if you see that India with the population, with this population, we have done very, very well in managing this COVID-19 pandemic. Now, India is also developing into a big healthcare industry where there are a lot and lot of employments across India too. Now, when I was talking about this healthcare professionals, allied healthcare professionals, now, I say, who are these healthcare professionals? When I talk about this, they belong to a large group of professional categories. It may be physiotherapy, it may be occupational therapy, now ophthalmic sciences, nutritional sciences, medical laboratory sciences, you have renal dialysis, you have nutrition sciences, and physician assistant and community health services, surgery-related technology, and so on and so forth. Now, you know that they play a crucial role as the pillars in the healthcare system. And they are very much required into the delivery of the healthcare to the society. Now, if you observe, if you keep observing, you see. Now, when you have heard of this RT-PCR test, you heard of this rapid antigen test, who are the ones who do this test? These are technicians. Now, if you see the sample, it starts with a sample collection, how a sample is collected. If you're not good enough, the sample is not collected properly, your results are not accurate. And definitely your treatment also depends on the diagnosis, the result what the technicians put up and give. So now you know how important are the technicians to help in the diagnosis, management, treatment, and also rehabilitation. Also, when it comes to physiotherapy, it's rehabilitation too. So it's very, very important that we have a skilled allied healthcare professional, which is a base for this healthcare system. Now, there is an ample international evidence suggesting that the empowered healthcare, allied healthcare professionals, they are the leaders of the change, playing critical role in improving the healthcare services and also delivery of these healthcare services. Because of the scarcity of the medical doctors, nurses to a certain extent, there's a great demand for this technologies. And as you know, the world now is technology-based. Every single field is technology, technology everywhere. Now, even in medical field is also not out of this. If you observe, you had gadgets earlier, you used to draw blood, and to give a blood report, it would take days. Now it's not so. Everything is technology-based. You have all technology seeped, even surgery for that matter. It need not be physical, it's robotic surgery now. The robots operate. But who is going to man all this? All the technologies are fine. Now, earlier, you need intelligence, like you need doctors to use their intelligence if they want to scan a patient, find out what's wrong, things like that. The technology is so very improved, the machine gives out everything, all the probable things what's there. Now, but who is going to operate this? So we need technologists, we need technicians who are going to operate this and thereby assist the healthcare system. Now, here, to go into the healthcare the courses as such, it's a four-year BSc, it's a four-year graduate program. The first 3 years are your course program. The fourth year is your internship, where you're rigorously trained so that you go out of the institution as a skilled professional who is in great demand in any of the employment field. Now, the first year, I want you all to know that the first year, you read anatomy. You know by now that because you're all science students, it just describes all the parts of your body and the organs, disposition, ways, your heart, your kidney, your lungs, your bones, muscles, so on and so forth. And it's all about the physiology, which is, again, the function. How are these functions? How do these organs function to keep you in good health? And you study biochemistry, where in a cellular level, you see how the basic cellular reactions are there to coordinate all these functions and therefore keep you in health, and how these cellular functions are altered when you're in disease. Now, you also study microbiology. There is nothing about the microbes, the same viruses, the bacteria, and also bacteria, viruses, and other pathogens, now, which is in the forefront as of now. Then you also study pathology, which is the disease. You know, you see the functions of these organs, how they get affected, and what's there. Now, these all these you study in the first year. Isn't it very interesting to all of you? And these are the same subjects with the medical students also study along with. Now, that's why you're partly already into the medical field by knowing all this. Second year onwards, second and third year, you have in these courses, you have programs pertaining to your specialty, whichever you want to choose. If you are medical laboratory technology, you get into those programs pertaining to medical lab. There, so on and so forth. Now we have our colleagues who will get into details of this, of all these courses, medical lab, medical imaging, then anesthesia, emergency, trauma care, all these things. Now, during that also, you're extensively trained on hands. Other than theory, you have practical classes where you're trained on hands. You get to operate the machines. And also you have machine learning as a part of this on how this these machines function and even the troubleshooting, everything. So you're trained in all that. So you're complete technicians where you're confident. Now, where can this happen? Now, can it happen in standalone institutions which do not have hospitals, which do not have nursing homes and so on? No. This, if you want to come out as a confident, well-trained, the most skilled professional, you need to train the best of the best institutions. As Honorable Vice Chancellor was mentioning, you get this at Dayan Sagar University. The medical college here is a world-class. All the facilities are world-class. So you study along with the medical students. So what all the doctors are into that, you're also trained along with them. And huge equipments, which go into crores and lakhs. The cost of these equipments, which many institutions cannot afford, they are there at CDSAM. You get to see them. You get to lay your hands on them. You get to train on them. Now, this is what you get at Dayan Sagar University. Now, coming to the courses, one which has not been touched upon is the renal dialysis, which the co-speakers would speak on the others. One is a renal dialysis. A word or two about renal dialysis I want to mention is that you know, you have heard in your family or in your circles or elsewhere when you browse, the web, you just see about this renal dialysis. Dialysis, the patient is undergoing dialysis. Now, what is dialysis? Like, you know, now, whenever the kidney doesn't function, is not doing its function, now, this renal dialysis machine takes over the role of the kidney. Now, it filters and purifies the blood using this machine is used that and helps to keep your fluid and electrolyte balance. The kidneys cannot do their job. It removes excess water, like, you know, all solutes, toxins from. That's the job of the kidney. When kidney can't do it, this machine does that. Now you have hemodialysis, peritoneal dialysis. Let's not go into details, which you can learn when you get into this. But this course is also very high in demand because many of them are getting into kidney failure. Now, when you say the kidney pathology or the kidney disease can occur due to various causes. There may be inflammation, there may be drug overuse, and many things. Like, if you heard of this diabetes, you know, every 1 in 2 in India is a diabetic. If not taken proper care of, ultimately they land up having a kidney failure. Same is with the hypertension also. So knowing the number of diabetics, knowing the number of hypertensive people, definitely you know that so many people are landing up to undergo the dialysis. And you also should know that it's only a management, it's not a cure. Cure is a healthy kidney replacement, which is not so much because the technique is difficult and the kidney donors are not very much. And hence, this renal dialysis has taken up a premier position in the treatment of his kidney ailments. And you know, once a renal dialysis patient, until he has got the kidney transplantation, he continues to be a patient. be a patient of Israel dialysis. Therefore, what happens is that the number goes on increasing day by day, day by day, where every patient keeps taking renal dialysis. The least is twice a week, sometimes more than that. So in emergency also, sometimes we need to do it. So that's, you have job opportunities just like that. It's very hard to get this renal dialysis technicians. And the beauty of this is you can have your, if you're a very skilled profession, you can have your own center. You need not depend on a hospital. The career opportunities is in nursing homes, hospital renal dialysis centers, in a government sector, where you can even get into the administrative post there. Or if you want to do research, you can do a post-graduation, you can do research on the kidney pathology, come out with newer techniques because you're into technology. So there's so much of opportunities. And the thing here is you can have, you can practice independent. You can have a dialysis machine by yourself and practice independently too. Now that's a plus point. That's a plus point here where the machine doesn't cost much and definitely you can go on about this. The placements are fantastic in case of renal dialysis. Now, I want also let you know that in India itself, the jobs in this healthcare sectors are growing enormously. Across the world, WHO says that there may be around 40, by 2030, they're saying 40 million jobs will be created in the healthcare sector. And the majority of them would be allied health science professionals. Now, when this is the case scenario, I think this is the best field if you want to stay in the medical field. Now, most of you are aspiring, yeah, I've taken science, I want to be a doctor. If you get into the medical field, there's nothing like that. In case you cannot get into a medical field and still want to be in the medical field, this is the best field to choose upon, where you can always assist the team. Usually now the scenario has changed. The healthcare delivery system has changed. It's a multidisciplinary team. You have the doctors, you have the nurses, you have the technicians, you have the advisor, all of them go together in treating or in deciding what a patient to be treated. And the role of the technicians is major. It's very, very important. Even from drawing a blood, if you don't draw a blood sample properly, the results are not accurate. Even from drawing a blood sample, how you store it, how you transport it, very, very much dependent on the results of the blood analysis. And based on this analysis, only the treatment is given to the patient. So you can understand how important you are, as technologists, or technicians, your role in the diagnosis, in the treatment, and also in the outcome of the treatment. Because once the patient has come, once the treatment is started, subsequently again, you have a blood test to know that how much they're improving. Right? Even on that, also, you're very helpful. So you can stay in them. Institution, or you can be in a medical college, hospitals, everywhere. You can just be within a medical team, a supporting team. So if you ask about the job security, when it comes to the job security, now there's nothing to look beyond the medical profession as of now. I don't see any doctor who says I'm out of job. I don't see any healthcare professional who says I've been laid off. They took me away, I'm out of job. If you're good enough, you're the best, you're skilled, you do find a job anywhere across the world. Even abroad, you have a lot of chances to get into this stream. So job the placement part of it and also the job security part of that is very, very high. The stakes are too high. Definitely, this will be the best. You should not look any beyond this particular courses for the job security part of it. I don't see anybody as of now till today who says, madam, I'm out of job, or I didn't land up with a job. That's not the case. There's a deficiency in the job market for the technicians. So my dear students, now not only this, in general also I'm telling you about the job placement options, but depending on this, our colleagues will talk to you about the job opportunities in all the other streams which are offering now. And further years, we'll come up with many more courses too. So they'll be speaking about this in a broad sense. I can only assure you that there'll be lot and lot opportunities and at Dhanasagar University, the medical college. With these courses, we are also in the process of having an MOU, we call it Memorandum of Understanding, MOU, with certain universities abroad and certain organizations abroad who are asking for us to to depute or even send these to utilize your services. Once you're here, they're requesting us to provide them the manpower, the services for the healthcare. So definitely, you're good enough, you come out, we'll see the placements for you people here. So dear children, all of you, I really advise you, go by your heart, think over what you should do, how you should go about. It's all the advice we are giving you, and it's the right time to get into the course. You need to go, and you're fit for which of these courses you can get into this. And wishing you all the very best. And thank you so much, Mr. Shinde, for providing this opportunity to address the students. Thank you so much. And all the best, dear children.
Ma'am, thank you so much. It's a deep information for all the students looking at a career in the allied health sciences. Thank you so much. We now would like to move on to the next speaker. I'd like to invite Dr. Shilpa HD, and she would be talking on the topic imaging technology and medical laboratory technology. Over to you, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Shinde. Good morning to all of you. I'll be speaking about medical lab technology and medical imaging technology, its career opportunities. See, as Madam and our Honorable Vice Chancellor already stressed, that if you are interested in science and especially in the healthcare field, and everybody cannot become doctors, that is MBBS or BDS, isn't it? So if you still have a flair of interest for these fields, if you ask me whether this is the right, can I choose these fields? I would say definitely yes. You can choose these allied health courses field. In particular, I'll be talking about this medical lab technologist course and the medical imaging technology course. Okay, so first coming to MLT. In short form, it is called as MLT, medical laboratory technology. Now, what is this medical laboratory technology? As the name itself suggests, see, more than 70% of the diagnosis and management of a patient illness is dependent on lab tests, isn't it? You might have experienced yourself or for your family members, whenever you go to a doctor, most of the time a blood test will be ordered. So these medical lab technologists work in the labs and assist doctors in making a proper diagnosis and managing the patient by doing various tests on blood and other specimens. So as it is written, they are chemistry, biology, and physiology based courses which deal with the diagnostic testing processes, okay, for not only for detection, but also in the management of the disease, whether the patient is responding to the treatment, how is his prognosis, whether he's improving or any modification in treatment needs to be done. So for all these things, a doctor would definitely request a blood test. So the whole diagnostic testing process, this medical lab technology course or technician will be handling. Now, what are the diagnostic processes? As Madam already told, it starts from the collection of the sample or specimen. Okay, collection of the samples, separation, analyzing, testing it, even reporting. You'll have to be reporting it, maintaining data. Quality assurance is a very important field, which itself is growing to be an independent field in the MLT, and overall supervision of the lab and so many things the diagnostic process will be dealing with. Next slide, please. Yeah, why you have to choose a course in MLT? As I already told you, if you're interested in science, not everybody can choose MBBS or BDS. It has a lot of value now, okay? Because if doctors are considered heroes, we need our heroes too, okay? We need a lot of supporting staff, be it MLT or be it imaging X-rays, radiographers. So it has a lot of value in the present day. job market and work atmosphere. You will not be directly dealing with the patients, but it is, in that way it is calm and you can actually enjoy your work atmosphere because it doesn't involve much of a patient interaction, but definitely you will be supporting from your point of view. And it has excellent employment outlook. It has a stable and secure career, as Madam already stressed, if not this lab, another lab, anywhere. You can have a wide variety, not only in labs, I'll be talking in my future slides, you will be having opportunities everywhere apart from lab, okay? So quick job opportunities. And then one of the careers, this MLT and medical imaging technologists with highest growth rate. I will be showing you actual real-time statistical figure of what is the growth rate of these jobs in my next slide. It has high demand and very, very competitive salaries. Next slide, please. So this is the growth rate of an MLT technician. As you're seeing here from 2012, other industries, the orange one is all other industries and the yellow one is the MLT, medical laboratory technician. You can see compared to all other industry, the job market or the job demand has grown for up to 30% in 2021. And it will show this increasing trend in future also. As you already know, with emerging diseases like this pandemic COVID-19, these medical lab technicians are in great demand and it has a very, very rapidly increasing growth rate in the present day job market. Next slide, please. Okay, so what are the specialty areas you can be, looking for specialization? See, this is one field which has, you need not actually do a specialization course. If you are interested, if you are very ambitious, yes, it has opportunities or it has things like you can do higher education also in the field. But otherwise, if you're not so ambitious and if you want to stop at BSc MLT and still work on the specialty areas, you can definitely do it. Once you take up a job and work for a period of 3 to 5 years in that particular field, automatically you will be given the experience certificate and you can take up that field as a specialization field. Okay, that is a major advantage of this field. What are the specialty areas you can be looking forward to work? It is your clinical chemistry, where we'll be doing many blood tests like glucose, urea, creatinine, and other things. Hematology, blood counts, that is a part of pathology. Histopathology, which will be dealing mainly with biopsies. Yes, transfusion medicine, that is blood banking, is again a major area in which you will have a wide variety of opportunity to work with in the blood centers, blood bank, and in transfusion medicine. Clinical immunology and clinical microbiology. You can specialize in microbiology like cultures, detecting various organisms, and you can continue with that specific work area. Molecular diagnostics. You have heard RT-PCR is being done for COVID, isn't it? That is one of the molecular diagnostics field. So if you specialize in that, you can work in high-end laboratories which deal with these DNA, RNA, and other molecular diagnostic processes. Phlebotomy is sample collection. Sample collection can be either a part of your routine work or now with the advent of this digital lab, off-site labs, people come for home collection, isn't it? So the patient really don't have to go to a lab. So these technicians will be employed as special only for phlebotomists. Okay, if you specialize in these areas, you can be employed to go and collect samples from different places. Quality management system, audits and accreditation, as I've already mentioned, you can do add-on courses. Okay, you can do fellowship programs, add-on courses in quality management, and you will be employed as quality manager or in the quality management system in any lab or a multinational company also. Laboratory information system analyst. Now, what is this LIS? See, now earlier we used to write all the reports using a pen by hand. Now it is not like that. We have a computer generated report. And also even from the machine to the report format, the machine automatically transfers the reports, okay, to our lab computer. So what is that called? This is what is called as lab information system. So you can specialize if you are a little bit tech savvy and if you want to, explore the software field also alongside doing this MLT course, you can definitely do it. And you can take special courses in the LIS system, and you can be employed as a laboratory information system analyst, which deals with a little bit of software system. And you can be employed in drug testing laboratories, toxicology, forensic toxicology labs, and forensic science labs. So you can see a wide area of specialty fields where you can actually pursue your interests. Okay, next slide, please. Next slide. Yeah, what are the possible career areas in medical laboratory technology? It has wide career opportunities both in the public sector and in the private sector. That is, you can get government jobs and also in the private sector. So you can be employed in these medical laboratories, clinical or medical laboratories in the hospitals, standalone hospitals, or either in a medical college, or just these labs. You have seen many places where only the labs are there. They are not attached to the hospital. They are called as standalone labs. So you can get employment in standalone labs, or labs attached to a hospital, or labs attached to a medical college hospital. You can get jobs in the blood center. As I already told you, blood center and transfusion medicine, you can get jobs there. In pharmaceutical labs is another growing area where MLT technicians or technologists will be employed in pharmaceutical labs, which make and test various drugs. These are the time-tested, you know, career opportunities. Less explored or less known career opportunities are in multinational companies. Very few people will know that they have opportunities in multinational companies which are involved in manufacturing our equipments and kits. You know, for diagnosis, we use a lot of machines. So those companies which make those machines also employ. This is one of the very, very fascinating areas where you can actually hold top positions. And then, you know, as an application specialist or a scientist, or also in their research and development wing. I personally know many of the medical lab technicians now who are employed in multinational companies, and they are having a, you know, a very top post and a respectable position in the society. If you want a little bit, you know, less semi-professional job, you can be employed as a medical lab technologist in labs attached to the medical college student lab. That is, you know, the MBBS students will come. So we need to conduct practicals for them. So they will be the technicians. There will be technicians who assist us in preparing the reagents and, you know, making the students do some experiments. So you can be employed in those labs as well. And dairy industry, water testing industry is another area where you will be sought after, because, you know, they do a lot of microbial testing and all those things. You can get an employment opportunity even there. Next slide, please. Can I have my next slide? Yeah. So these are all technical areas. If you want to have a supervisory roles like a quality manager, lab manager, hospital outreach coordinator, after some time of you know, you doing these technical jobs and you having been employed in these areas, you will be promoted to these posts like quality manager or lab manager, which is mainly an administrative role, and you will have supervisory duties there. LIS and data analyst, I have already told. Vaccine manufacturing lab, this is a very, very important field, especially you've seen so many vaccines coming up now for COVID-19, isn't it? You can have, you know, if you have adequate experience and a little bit of, you know, higher education or a fellowship degree, you can actually be employed in vaccine manufacturing industries also. If you're interested in teaching and if you want to join the academia, yes, after doing an MSc, MLT or even a PhD, you can be employed in the academic like medical colleges or, you know, paramedical colleges for teaching purposes. Research, yes, research, if you are, you know, really looking forward, if you're patient to go in for research, you can definitely do that as well. And you can be, of course, employed in the industry as, you know, quality assurance, even in the sales division, scientific writer and occupational health department. Next slide, please. So if you want to pursue your higher education, there is a chance for that also. You can do your MSc, you can do your PhD, you can actually do various certificate courses in quality assurance, quality management. You know, the scope is, there are innumerable opportunities in this field, whether you want to do higher education or whether you want to settle with only BSc. it's up to you. I would say the sky is the limit. So there is a lot of opportunities for these medical lab technologies. Next slide, please. Yes. Now I will touch upon radio imaging technology. See, radio imaging and medical lab technology, they are two arms of diagnostics field, isn't it? Now I told medical lab technologists will be dealing with blood or specimen for testing. Now imaging technology, suppose the doctor wants to see the interior of the body. Okay, so for any disease diagnosis or management, you know, various equipments or various technologies are employed, like X-ray, CT scan, MRI, which will give an indication of what is happening inside the body morphologically. So these technologists who have pursued a course in medical imaging technology will be doing, you know, will be employed in these centers, which either do X-ray, CT scan or MRI. And there are various others also, like there is mammography for detection of breast cancer. And this is a field which is highly developed and in demand at present. The radio imaging can be used for diagnostic purpose. It can be interventional, like when an angiogram is done, you know, a contrast is passed, isn't it? So with minimal interventional procedures, these radio diagnosis is used for a minimal interventional procedure. So it could be interventional or it can be therapeutic, like in cancers. So these technologies can, after having specialization or experience in those fields, can be either employed in diagnostic radio imaging or interventional techniques like a cath lab technician or in therapeutic, that is radio oncology technician. So you have a wide arena of, you know, opportunities here as well. You can do your specialization in nuclear radiology, radiation oncology, cath lab technician, neuroradiology, gastroenterology, you know, intestinal radiology, and the list goes on. Okay, there is I have a time limit, so I can't just keep going on. What I want to stress is you can specialize in a lot of, you know, the spectrum is really, really very wide, either for MLT or for medical imaging technologists to explore. Next slide, please. Yeah, you have you can be employed in hospitals, clinics, diagnostic or imaging centers, you know, as CT technician, X-ray technician, MRI technician, and image equipment companies. As I told for MLT, these also, you know, the X-ray machines or CT machines are manufactured by certain companies, right? So you can actually be employed in those multinational companies, or if you are interested in academics and research, you can explore that area as well. Even you have an opportunity or a chance for higher education even here. Next slide, please. Yes, so if you look at this slide, in whichever direction you go, you have opportunity, whether you want to do higher education, whether you want to settle down with a startup job, everywhere you see this one, allied health courses is like, you know, there are opportunities everywhere. Next slide, please. Yeah, so I put this diagram because you see, doctors, yes, we are definitely heroes, but we need a lot of, you know, help from our supporting staff and from the allied health course professionals, okay? Because more than 80% of the diagnosis and management, clinical decision making is based on the lab test results or based on the X-ray or based on the CT, MRI, etc. So, you know, these medical lab technologists or imaging technologists play a very, very important role in today's healthcare sector. And as I have already told, there are very wide opportunity areas, job opportunities, a secure, stable job. So I would encourage more and more of y'all to choose this profession, and especially in our institute, we will give equal importance, and whatever area you want to explore, there is an opportunity. We will ensure that we will, at Dhyanand Sagar, we will provide you with that opportunity to explore either research or specialization areas you want. We will provide you with the opportunity. So thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to talk on this subject, and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for a detailed brief on both the programs. Thank you so much. I would now like to take the opportunity of inviting Dr. Prashant Kumar. And Dr. Prashant Kumar, over to you, sir.
Very warm good morning to all of you. And I've been asked to speak about the course perspectives of some of the paramedical courses. First, I would like to bring your attention to what would be the extra privilege of doing it at CD Saimar, that is Dr. Chandramma Dayanand Sagar Institute of Medical Education and Research. It is a very smart campus, a huge sprawling campus of 140 acres with a 1,350 bed state-of-the-art hospital. The environment here is that which encourages creativity amongst all the students. It stimulates innovation and motivates scholarly pursuits. And it has the right opportunity to revolutionize the nature of medicine, science, society for the national and global welfare. So with this motto in mind, this the infrastructure provided in this campus is state of the art. As you can see, these are the hematology and pathology labs where our students of medical, paramedical courses will be attending. This is the clinical physiology lab. And the left of this side is the histopathology lab, where slides will be made and details will be studied about the various tissues, both the normal and the abnormal ones. This is a beautiful anatomy museum where a lot of specimens are available. For all these basic courses, in the first year, you do learn about anatomy and physiology, which deals with structure and functions. And these infrastructural abilities make it very easy for you to learn. Then there's a very good state-of-the-art dialysis center in the hospital. You see how huge it is. And people with who come with a keen interest to learn about dialysis are exposed to one of the best facilities. Similarly, the operation theater complex is sprawling. It's huge. It has multiple operation theaters with state-of-the-art equipment. And you see here in this slide on the left side, as the doctor is operating, there are other OT technology students technicians who really are a big help when it comes to operations. A surgeon cannot operate all by himself or herself unless there is the presence of this particular professional people. So basically, if you look at the course prospects of Bachelor of Science in Anesthesia and Operation Theater Technology, it is, first let me briefly tell you about the syllabus in this curriculum. It has initial introduction to anatomy and physiology, where the students are exposed to, as I said, the structural and functional aspects of the normal anatomy, the normal physiology of a person. You learn in required details about all these various structures and functions so that you can use this knowledge and apply it later on to the field itself. Then there will be a big coverage on surgical instruments and procedures like preoperative consideration, protection of patient during the surgical procedure is going on, transfer of patient from OT to out or from outside to the inside, post-operative care. And different surgical specialties have different instruments. So the student is exposed to the instruments of the general surgery, instruments of ophthalmic or the eye surgery, instruments of the otorhinolaryngology, which is ENT, and also of the vascular surgery. So you will get exposure to instruments used in various surgical specialties. You'll also be taught about the procedures themselves in detail, like the neck surgery, the breast surgery, the chest, the gastrointestinal surgery. All of you would have heard about the various scopes used in esophagoscopy, gastroscopy, colonoscopy. So the technician is a person who actually handles these instruments, equipment, keep them ready, and hands them over to the doctor or the surgeon who is going to use them in his or her field at that particular time. And then you will also be exposed to various gynecological and obstetric surgical procedures. So some of the lady candidates who enter this field also specialize into this, and they become very favorite students of famous gynecologists, because a specialization into this itself is possible. Then there are genitourinary surgical procedures which you will be exposed to. Thoracic procedures like bronchoscopy, mediastinoscopy, wedge resection of lung. We have even exposure to cardiovascular surgery in the syllabus. Then the orthopedic surgery, which in itself is a huge field. Neurosurgical procedures, plastic surgical procedures. As I already mentioned, ENT and ophthal and pediatric procedures. Then the student gets a brief bird's eye view into anesthesia too, because both of these go hand in hand in learning about OT technology. That's why this field is called this way, as Bachelor of Science in Anesthesia and Operation Theatre Technology. In anesthesia, the student will be exposed to the different types of anesthesia, like general anesthesia and the conduction anesthesia. And in that, the spinal, the epidural, local anesthesia, the topical anesthesias, methods for preparation of the patient so that the anesthetist comes and administers these various forms of anesthesia. Different surgical procedures require different safety procedures to go hand in hand, and also different ways of administering anesthesia. So there should be a lot of discipline and safety among the personnel who are involved in the operation room, preparation of instrumental trays. Even a student gets a look into national health programs and policies, and the safety of the patient throughout all this. Though no doubt why vicarious responsibility is that of the surgeon, but the OT technology student gets an exposure to all these various equipment and safety procedures that they have to help and adapt to the surgeon while he is operating. So it is a challenging career, no doubt. It is for those who look for intellectual satisfaction from their career. This has so much skills to offer. And a surgeon cannot be a hero or heroine by themselves, but with the background work of all these technologies. So it's a challenging career in various hospitals, nursing homes, trauma care centers, emergency care centers, and intensive care and coronary care units. So you can further specialize into these narrower specialties and specialize and get into those particular units also. Apart from this, there is a lot of overseas and domestic employment opportunities, quite very well in medical institutions. Many medical colleges across India, we know there are 540 medical colleges. There's plenty of opportunity if one joins a medical college in both career research and also the R&D centers, the research and development centers of manufacturing units of medical equipment manufacturers are nowadays employing these skilled people who are trained in these courses. And it is a very, very interesting and special career. You are directly specializing into a surgical specialty by getting into this and getting a bird's eye view of anesthesia also, and taking care of the patient during the most needy hours of a surgical emergency. So students and the parents, this is a wonderful course. And to do it in a medical college as well equipped and as from latest infrastructure as the Anand Sagar Medical College will be a great opportunity. I would welcome all of you to come and experience it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for the wonderful information. So you can stop the screen sharing.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. So over to the students now, and we would like to inform all the students that the admissions for the programs that we have listed here, all the five new BSc programs are now available. And we have opened up the admission about a week back. So all the students who are interested could actually go into our website, dsu.edu.in, and they can fill in the applications. And we'll have our career guidance experts calling you guys and guiding you with the entire admission process, the eligibility process, so that you could come in and book your seats. And while the examination results will be out soon, you could go ahead with the provisional admissions subject to you meeting the criteria. We also have given our helpline numbers 4646180. You could call in on those numbers and you could speak to our career guidance experts, and they will guide you with some more information in case if you need. And you could also mail us. Once you go to the website, you'll see all the email IDs available, wherein you can mail us in case if you need any more information. I would like to thank all the speakers today for their time and available today for giving the guidance to the students. A big round of thanks to the Honorable Vice Chancellor and to the Honorable Dean for giving us time to inform about the various career options, the opportunities, the programs, the benefits to all the students. I'm sure this would have been a lot of information and the guidance to all of you. In case if any of the parents and the students feel about having more information, please get back to us. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day ahead and stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ashanda.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
It's already late. Where's Arjun?
He's looking for universities, right? Maybe he's held up there.
You look so tense. By the way, did you get to choose the university?
No, I'm unable to find an university that meets my requirements.
Whoa, meet your requirements? What exactly are you looking for?
I'm looking for a place that gives me an opportunity to grow, to excel, to invent, and to innovate. I want to be a part of an institution that paves my way to discover myself and to witness the world moving forward in technology. I want to go to a place that sets a futuristic pattern of education filled with ideas and radical performances. Basically, I want to live my dream.
Dayanand Sagar University. Live the dream.